Hello friends, in this video we are going to understand what is quasi steady state. You must have heard this term or you must have seen this term in the numericals relating to fed batch culture, and in this video we are going to understand what actually this is. So let us first understand what is the meaning of quasi. So quasi means a thing which appears to be something but not really is. Okay, a thing which appears to be something but not really is, and in this case it is steady state. So quasi steady state is a state which appears like steady state but actually it is not. So it is not entirely steady state, but it appears like steady state because of some of its properties, and we are going to see what are those. So the first property of quasi steady state is that there is very high biomass density and there is almost complete depletion of the substrate. Very high biomass density and almost complete depletion of the substrate. So the rate at which the substrate concentration is changing is approximately zero. The rate at which biomass concentration is changing is approximately zero, and the rate at which product concentration is changing is also approximately zero. So under quasi steady state, the rate at which biomass, the rate at which substrate and product, all of these change is approximately zero. So we can say that biomass concentration, substrate concentration and product concentration are approximately constant under quasi steady state. Okay, now one important thing about quasi steady state is there is a change in volume. Okay, the volume does not remain constant because there is an inflowing medium but there is no removal of substances in fed batch culture. We know that there is only addition of nutrients but not removal. So there is an increase in the volume, and if there is an increase in the volume, we know the formula of dilution rate is F by V. So if the V increases, the F by V entire term is going to decrease, which means the dilution rate decreases. And if the dilution rate decreases under steady state, we know that mu is equals to D, so the specific growth rate is also going to decrease. So it is said that volume, dilution rate, specific growth rate and the total biomass inside the bioreactor, they are not constant. Because if there is some growth rate, the total biomass is going to increase. The volume is already increasing. Now the dilution rate, we see it changes with the volume, and mu, it changes with the dilution rate. So all of these terms are not constant, but these terms are approximately constant. Now why do we need to study this quasi steady state? So we are studying this quasi steady state so that we can easily calculate the yield, the biomass production, the dilution rate, maximum specific growth rate, substrate concentration, all of these parameters in the fed batch culture. So if we see that in quasi steady state, mu is approximately equal to dilution rate, therefore D is equal to mu max S upon Ks plus S. Okay, so we are using the terms which we used actually in the continuous stir tank reactor. Okay, the terms which we actually used in continuous stir tank reactors steady state, we are using those terms in the case of quasi steady state, a false steady state. So here mu is equals to approximately equal to D, therefore D is equals to mu max S upon Ks plus S. And if you see here, we just derived a formula in the last video for a relationship between biomass concentration and substrate, and it was like X is equals to yield, which is the amount of biomass produced per unit substrate multiplied by substrate flowing in minus the steady state substrate concentration. Now in fed batch culture, we know that there is no accumulation of the substrate inside. Most of the substrate, as soon as it enters, is consumed. Okay, so as soon as the substrate enters the bioreactor, it is consumed. So S in is very much high than the S which is present inside the bioreactor, or which is always present inside the bioreactor. So we neglect this S term and we write X is equals to, which is biomass concentration is equals to yield into the substrate inflowing. Okay, the substrate concentration inside the feed. Okay, so we are going to neglect the term of the steady state substrate concentration, because in fed batch culture the substrate which is flowing in entirely gets consumed inside the fed batch culture, or it almost gets consumed inside the fed batch culture. There is no removal of substrate as we saw in the continuous stir tank reactor. Okay, so there is no such thing in the fed batch culture. There is no removal of substrate. Therefore, S in the concentration of substrate which is flowing in is much higher than the concentration of substrate which is left out in the bioreactor. Okay, so we also get this formula which is for the biomass. Now if you get any numerical relating to fed batch culture and quasi steady state, you can use both of these formulas. You can now answer all the questions related to the concepts of the quasi steady state. In the description of this video, I have given a few questions which also appeared in the previous year gate biotechnology examinations. So please do go through those questions. The answers are mentioned in the description only. Thank you.